The lead investigator took the stand today in the Ryan Widmer retrial, and his testimony may have hurt the prosecution's case. News 6's Karin Johnson is live tonight with our number two story. Karin?
Well, Cherie, obviously that will be up to the jury to decide, but he did go on the record saying he has no idea why Ryan Widmer might have killed his wife, Sarah.
Sarah didn't have a boyfriend.
We did not verify anything like that. That's correct, sir.
Ryan didn't have a girlfriend.
We did not verify that.
No life insurance.
That's correct.
No suspicious phone calls, no money troubles, no drug problems, according to the lead investigator, Lieutenant Jeff Braley. Although prosecutors don't need a motive to prove a case, Braley told jurors today he can't provide one, can't say why Ryan Widmer would have wanted his wife Sarah dead. But Braley says he knows what he saw inside the Widmer's bathroom, clothes and magazines on the bathroom floor.
Did you notice anything unusual about any of the clothing, magazines, or other items on the floor at that time?
At that time, they all appeared completely dry.
Braley says that raised a red flag, because if Sarah had been in the tub, as Ryan told dispatchers, where was the water? But in cross-examination, defense attorneys attacked the way Lieutenant Braley handled the scene.
You would agree that there's nothing in the investigation where the weather conditions, the environment in the house, was ever recorded, correct?
I believe that's correct, sir.
An important piece to this puzzle, if Sarah's body was dry, as first responders had testified. Also, the defense suggested the evidence inside the home, including the bathtub, could have been contaminated. See, police didn't tape it off as a crime scene until a day and a half after Sarah died.
If a crime scene is left unsecured and other people have access to it, that changes the integrity of the evidence in the crime scene, correct?
It could.
And on the stand right now is Warren County Coroner Dr. Russell Updegrove. He's the one who initially ruled Sarah's death a homicide, and you'll hear why coming up tonight at 6. Reporting live in Lebanon, Karin Johnson, News 5.